So it's Gao Zhengrui to start it off. Best of five match. Love all. Ripping forehand, Jose. He says deep to the line. Still a lot to prove here. The young French superstar, three-time consecutive national champ. I like it. He's got a mind of his own here. Walks to a beat of his own drum. What an awkward ball. Slows it way down, puts a little bit of side spin on it. France has a rich history. Wow. That touch. It's a baby strawberry, it seems, with a bit of backspin on it. I was going to say the French team has a history of playing free, training, creative play. Right into the middle, the crossover point. Gao Zhengrui having to twist his upper body to try and create some space for this forehand. That's what the middle's all about, forcing your opponent to make a quick decision and pivot. Flawless start here for the French superstar. If you haven't heard of the LeBron brothers, welcome to table tennis. The whole world has been talking about them for over a year now. And on the parallel, 6-6 coming into the first towel break. Again, two brothers with very different styles. Alexis LeBron raced ahead. Younger brother Felix, now 17, 3 years the younger. World ranked number 5. Ooh, second bounce on the table, but incredible touch for a ball that had just bounced a second time. Gao Zhengrui on the scoreboard now. The drastic difference between these last two shots of Alexis LeBron. He plays it soft and then rips the next shot. That said, Gao Zhengrui finding his way back in with 2 points now. Long serve and the consistent spin to the baseline. It's a best of five, so there's not a lot of time to get used to your opponent here. In these best of fives, upsets a little bit more common. Alexis having beaten the former world number one, Fang Shandong. A similar best of five. Fighting and a little gallop lap after to celebrate the point, keep the blood flowing. Gao Zhengrui is gonna have his hand up quite a lot because Alexis serves very fast. Both him and his brother have some of the fastest rhythm in the game. They serve faster than others. Hand in the air. And at the second towel break, again, they come up every 6 points to make sure the players don't stall too much. You will see Gao Zhengrui with his hand in the air just to make sure that he's not rushed, that he's at the table ready when he's on the receive. When he's the server, has a little bit more control of that timing. Alexis gets the net back, finishes the point. Offering another apology there, but right to the middle, you could see that backhand coming up to protect the elbow. Made for an uncomfortable ball. Soft flick to the wide forehand. It's tricky. One to get there that wide, two to get back in position, but now 6 game points for Alexis. And he only needs the one. Short with top and side spin from the backhand, and 11-4. Just checking the lighting here on the toss. Maybe if there's any air conditioning coming through. Smooth backhand. Crazy to think that both him and his brother weren't in the top 1,000 about 2 years ago. The question used to be, as France can only send no more than 2 players in singles, who is going to join Simon Gauzy to represent France? Now it seems that the brothers will be the 2.
2-1.
But a lot of events in table tennis, just coming off the Singapore Smash this year. Champions Incheon, Saudi Smash early May. The ITTF World Cup coming up. Those 4 events equals a lot of points for players to quickly move in the world rankings. 2 points apiece here, much better start for Gao Zhengrui.
2-3.
Now, both of these teams, Chinese Taipei team and the French team, were quite starring in Busan at the World Championships.
3-0.
Both of these young men were both quite integral parts of their team's success. Bronze medalist, the Chinese Taipei team, Gao Zhengrui, Lin Winru, and Zhuang Zhiyuan. And the Frenchmen, silver medalists for the first time since 1997. 27 years. Ooh, second time.
4-3.
Dribbler over the net, drop shots are not easy. Gao Zhengrui, with the help of the net, able to get a winner on a drop shot. Could see there the way he backed up the racket, though, to absorb the bounce. Heavy spin coming in, a much needed point for the mojo and the morale here of Alexis Lebrun. Oh, well, now sets up what could have been a lollipop, a windshield wiper, but goes for the tomahawk serve for an outright point. There it was, the lollipop that I was describing earlier, a serve that Alexi does and not too many else in the men's game at this point in time. 5 points apiece, dead even here. Nice touch just behind the net. Short ball, Gao Zhengrui looking to get aggressive, goes for the flick inside the table. It's crazy to think that this player here, Gao Zhengrui, is playing on a team with his coach. Usually your coach is on your bench. They're teammates. Zhuang Zhiyuan.
7-5.
As much adrenaline and energy as you can imagine. The foot stomp we saw yesterday from Truls Morgaard, I think, could definitely be matched out here by Alexis Lebrun, should he have any frustration. He wears his heart on his sleeve, and he leads by two.
8-5.
Right back to where it came from. Good read, quick movement to the wide forehand, and a three-point lead. Adjustment made on the receive this time around. Tomahawk serve, and Gao Zhengrui has an answer to shut down the third ball attacker, at least keep it a little bit less effective. But in this one, he earns himself the fourth ball. Gao Zhengrui getting the opening attack in that rally to make it a two-point game. Tough to counter exchange in the counter loops here with Alexis Lebrun. He moves into the table so well. Generates a lot of power and pace on that shot. Physically, quite a force, Alexis Lebrun. Coach Nat Molan has worked with both of the Lebrun brothers for a long, long time. Good placement here, bit of side spin on it, wide to the backhand. And you've got someone behind the table. That's the way to go, unless you can hit it out of reach to the forehand. Keep them pinned on the backhand side. Why is that? Because generally, the backhand with a shorter stroke is much tougher from behind the table to really cause threat in a counter-attacking game.
Late 9-8.
Acknowledged by both quickly. Let service, but Alexi doing what you should. Play it until you hear it from the umpire. Heavy spin and the gallop around the court. A tight game here. Spin comes into the middle, quick to get low and step around Alexis Lebrun. And now it's two game points for the upper seed. Backhand to backhand, Gao Zhengrui still in it. Again, training in Kaohsiung with Zhuang Zhiyuan has led him to here. 1 point between them. The spin to the wide forehand, and a big point here. Found his way to do it way more in game number two than game number one.
one low.
And a well-placed serve appeared to be top and side spin. Half long to the forehand side, but short enough to force a flick or something more passive.
Low two.
Two good serves out the gates here. Off the top of the net here, but earning the attack, Alexis Lebrun. Strong opening backhand and no mercy on the follow-up forehand.
2-0.
Quickly leveled, Gao Zhengrui in a tough position here. If this point doesn't go his way, I think a conversation might be called, a timeout by the coach. Set up well and spun down the middle. There it is, the timeout is called. Two serving three. Incredible point, Alexis Lebrun all over, moves it around. This is the point of the event so far for me. Physical fitness, the exhaustion you must feel on the other side. Gao Zhengrui chasing everything. That backhand, Alexis Lebrun not only plays that ball from about head height, but is moving back into the table as he does it. Talk about multitasking. How do you deal with that? How on earth do you deal with that? It's a two-point lead here.
5-2.
This receive right there. It's rare to see a player tricked that much by a serve. The ball flies off the table by a meter.
3-5.
Gao Zhengrui doesn't have his timeout left. He did have the towel break. I think he took it during the replays that we saw of that incredible point. Mouth-watering action.
2-3-6.
Surprising, constantly changing up his depths. Catches the edge of the racket here. Watch what Alexi does. Empty push, half long, leaving a bat breaker, as they say in England, a finger breaker, right near that baseline. Surprise, surprise, wide to the forehand. Gao Zhengrui was hoping for something deeper to the backhand side to step around, but waiting for Godot. Godot never came. Perfect placement there with that spin.
Let 7-3.
The confidence to catch the ball. I say that because if you catch the ball and there's a disagreement, the umpire doesn't say let, and the receiver says I didn't see a let, that's it, you lose the point.
5-7.
Good spin here, Gao Zhengrui making his way back in. 2 points between them now. Nice spin to the forehand. Alexi playing a little bit softer there. Change of pace, a big part of his game. But he's got the confidence and the power that we've seen already to get him this 7-point head start in the game.
Stop it.
Rushing forehand. The rock star celebration after, fired up. So good to watch. Bit of flair in the game. A 3-point lead here. Ooh, Gao Zhengrui moving in well to handle. A lot of players would have expected an attack here against this serve. Higher bounce. Alexi determined early that he wanted to play it short.
8-7.
1-point game now. Remember, Gao Zhengrui fighting to stay in this in a must-win situation for every game.
Yes.
Perfect combination. One to the middle and then quick off the bounce to the deep backhand. Gao Zhengrui earning that positioning in this point. Beautiful side swiping shot with the forehand. And level here. Was he down 3-7 earlier? Games have gone quickly.
Yes.
And this pattern is working so well. One to the middle, and he catches Alexei with the racket head a little bit straight up, playing a more passive block. As strong as Alexei is in the defensive game, with Gao Chengrui's timing on the follow-up shot, he's going to have to find ways to get more aggressive early on, even if it's in response to an opening attack.
Yes!
8-10.
It's probably the loudest sound of contact we've heard this match, especially on a receive so close to the baseline. A fearless attempt here, but 7 of the last 8 points to Gao Chengrui. And Gao Chengrui takes it. The Chinese Taipei teams. So Alexei Lebrun still up 2-1 now. Gao Chengrui saves this point from a very uncomfortable position. Manages to cover the middle with a forehand and then rip a backhand from behind the table, nice and shallow behind the net. Confidence and timing. This has always been a big difference. Again, we talk about continental strength. In Asia, speed has been the main factor. Recovery time close to the table. Players a little bit bigger, more massive in other parts of the world.
2-1.
Again, if it were wrestling, these two would not be playing in the same class. They'd be in different weight classes. It's part of the reason Felix and Alexei come into their chest bump at different angles.
2-0.
If you see Alexei and Felix playing doubles, they've got this awesome handshake and celebration that involves a chest bump at the end.
3-2.
Tell you more about it at the towel break. Well handled here with the change of pace. Alexei stays in the point. Shirt break and a towel break. So the European Summer Series in 2022, having a meal with Felix and Alexei at the end of their handshake. Alexei jumped almost straight up and Felix jumped into him. The angle, they both came in quite differently. Alexei said, well, if I jumped into him the way he jumped into me, he'd end up in the salad bar. True statement. Making his way back in, Alexei, but keeping the pressure on. Gao Chengrui just not allowing Alexei the time to really load up the backhand. Caught in between there, trying to put some forward motion on the drive. Just guide his way back into the table. But Gao Chengrui within 1 point now. Gotta love these points. The backhand counter down the line. Alexei causing threat on both wings from the backcourt. Watch him move back in, blitzing the table. Danger all around. So much pressure in every shot for Gao Chengrui. Chop block, a bit of side spin, a bit of underspin, but not too much racket motion on it. Alexei Lebrun. That one right there, you could see the curve on that ball as it bends into the backhand. The power of the forehand. And it's a 4-point lead. Alexei has been here before. Again, last game it felt like. Memory's a funny thing, especially mine. Gets rid of that one quickly. Be gone with ball. Gao Chengrui, can he pull off a similar comeback as he did in the last game? Continuing to wipe the brow and keep the sweat flowing here. Man on a mission, fast and in condition now. 5 points up, 3 points away. It's Gao Chengrui with a big second serve. Stealing the attack from inside the table at the baseline. Alexei Lebrun with a better answer to this serve. Last time Gao Chengrui did a similar serve, rotation a bit different here. A little underspin on it.
9-4.
Much needed point, one step in the right direction for Gao Zhengrui. Slow and spinny, shallow on the table. It is 6 game and match points for Alexis Lebrun. One save, Gao Zhengrui. Keeping his eye on the opponent here. Trying to sense what he's looking to do. Alexis Lebrun closes the door. So indeed, and a big victory.